recommendation to approve renewal, Microsoft Enterprise Agreement. Yes, sir.
Good evening, Mayor and Commissioners. The city's enterprise agreement with Microsoft expired on January 31st of this year. The new enterprise agreement will allow us to maintain licensing and support of all of our on-site infrastructure and have the ability to implement Microsoft 365. In doing so, we'll reduce the complexity of our licensing structure, consolidate several IT functions, and raise the quality of our platform. Microsoft 365 will also modernize and simplify IT management, administration, workflows, and offer additional security features and protections. This purchase was budgeted for this fiscal year in the amount of $153,612.98, with a cost of $153,964.70 for difference of $1,351.72. Based on a quick analysis using information from other organizations our size, the three-year ROI for implementing Microsoft 365 is approximately 165% of the tax rate. This calculation considers consolidation of systems, improvements in IT efficiency and management, and the additional collaborative capabilities amongst the city and business units. One good benefit is that all city employees will be entitled to discounted services and equipment through Microsoft. For example, a 30% discount is offered on Microsoft 365 for home use, and 10% on discounts on mobile tablets. So staff would recommend approval of the Microsoft Enterprise Agreement. I don't have to answer any questions.
And we'll approve our information security here too.
Yes, sir.
Also, you sit down, Mrs. Yeah.
Study. Okay. That's our license. So, any questions from the commission?
Need a motion.
Move to approve the renewal of the Microsoft Enterprise Agreement, Microsoft 365, the amount of $152,612.98.
Do we have a second?
Second.
Motion and a second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Thank you, sir. Matters from citizens and wanted art.
Good evening, all. Mr. Mayor, Commissioners, Mr. Williams, Mr. Hartman. I'm going to talk about Resolution 2302, the rules governing media coverage of city meetings. We'll keep this short. These rules are unconstitutional, according to the city attorney that I consulted yesterday on the resolution. I'll tell you that he used a lot more colorful language than that, and I have filed a complaint with the ACLU of Florida on behalf of VoxPopuli. These rules governing media coverage, particularly pertaining to seeking comments and interviews, infringe on the media's ability, indeed our responsibility, to question and report on public officials in public buildings such as this, at public meetings such as this. This is the job of the journalist, and it comes with the territory of being a public official. I've been on the phone and emailing with journalists all day, and I have heard nothing but surprise and shock about these new rules from local reporters who've read them. No other city that we cover has such rules. I cannot emphasize enough that this is not normal. The fact that this will come to a vote during the city manager's report and without benefit of public comment is also very problematic. This resolution is coming up now because VoxPopuli, my publication at wintergardenvox.com, has been critical of the city and dogged in demanding answers. The mayor, Mayor Reese, is critical of the work that we do, and he's on record saying that he does not like the way that I do things in Winter Garden, and this resolution is the result. I'm going to close with this. Yes, sir. Mayor Reese has no compunction about trampling constitutional rights. In 2014, he directed the chief of police to remove a man who refused to stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, a fact that I reminded him of recently. And now here we are with a resolution to curtail press freedom. This moves the city backwards, not forwards. Now, this resolution is going to come up
Yes, Mayor, one matter with respect to the dispute the city has with PureCycle. I don't know if John has already talked to you about the joint meeting between the Board of County Commissioners and the City Commission. This is a requirement for us to file a lawsuit against the county with respect to the county's approval of the use. So I think September 27th. It's a Monday at 6 p.m. at 10 o'clock.
February, you said?
That's February. That's it, Mayor. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
City Manager.
Good evening, Mayor Commissioners. Recently, we were approached by Little League for some possible food enhancements at the Little League complex. We have James Moody and Mark Kirkman here tonight. James is president. Board member, and they originally approached us with a conversation to convert the infield field 1, 2, 3 artificial turf. They also proposed to use some artificial mounds and install magnetic bases. We obviously had already adopted our current budget for this fiscal year, and this came after. The slide that I've got before you kind of shows the proposed improvements for the artificial turf for the infield. And the mounds and then the magnetic bases. It's much different than what I used to play on when I was a kid. But that's certainly, we are in support of these enhancements. The total cost for converting all three fields, which is the preference of Little League to do right now, is at $264,000. They've offered to contribute $90,000 towards the overall project, leaving us with the balance of $174,000 as a contribution to the project. As I just previously mentioned, we do support those fields, but one of the things that we did bring back to James and Mark was that we needed to include the senior field. In addition to that, we wanted to have Little League acknowledge that the city would not be responsible to fund or perform any maintenance, repair, or replacement of the artificial turf, which will be further defined in an MOU, and that Little League and the city would agree to formalize an operating and maintenance agreement from a more long-term perspective. So what I'd like to get approval from the commission is to move forward and give me the authority to execute an MOU, which would allow Little League to proceed with converting one field of choice and the city to contribute $10,000 to avoid value engineering of the base layer. Now, just prior to the commission meeting, I was talking to Mark and James, and their overall quote was for all three fields. So the cost to do one field may actually change.
It incorporates the clay, so it goes
appreciate it.
Oh, man.
I'm glad we're working. I hear rumblings about things that are going on. I'm glad it's being worked out with the league. I thought there were some issues in the outfield also with some holes and pits. Are we doing some general maintenance as well? So those holes, some of those holes still exist in some of the outfields?
Not like they've seen in the past.
Yeah.
But I will also guarantee you will be 16-year-olds that are out there looking for dragonflies.
They dig holes in
the past. Maybe some of them do a lot. I know you do a lot of self-maintenance too. So that's good. Okay.
Maybe so. Okay. So we'll get one field for this year and look at the rest of them the season soon. Working with the stewardship and things, I appreciate the city manager's work it is, and I do think that
while it might be slightly more expensive, I think the better approach given our soil is to do one now instead of the outlay of three for $250,000 and then find out that we're not getting the return.
Well, you're running on it at four, so it'd be the same.
Yeah,
we're
in the same,
which is a bigger field.
Yeah, there is some risk that by deferring the other three that there could be some cost increases, but there could be some cost reduction too.
So yeah, it's a risk mitigation.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, we need a motion.
Motion to approve the memorandum of understanding from Little League with authorization within the city manager's signature authority.
Okay, do we have a second?
Motion.
A second. All in favor, say
aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Thank you all.
Resolution 23-02. Resolution number 23-02, a resolution of the City Commission of the City of Winter Garden, Florida, adopting rules for public input and decorum at public meetings of the City Commission, providing conflict suitability and effective date.
City Manager.
Good evening, Mayor Commissioners. Resolution 23-02 updates and supersedes previous resolution of 2006-13 to include the new state statute and also establishes some criteria for the media. Stating the obvious that we all recognize that at a national level there's been a significant lack of public decorum that exists at all different levels of public meetings. So we felt like this was a good opportunity to update that old existing resolution, incorporate the new state statute, as well as some guidelines for the media. We've received some citizen complaints about media addressing the commission during public comments, which is really not the proper place for that to happen. So that's why some of that did come through from a staff's perspective. One of the changes that I would like to bring to the attention that's not existing in this resolution that's in the agenda packet is I had spoken myself today to Fox 35, WESH, WFTV, Spectrum News, one of the reporters had pointed out that there was some vague language that could possibly have them removed from a public meeting in pursuit of a story. After reviewing that and talking with the gentleman, I totally agreed. So under section 6 in the definition section, we have deleted unwanted interactions. And then we've also added section 8 that would allow this to extend to other boards, to the other boards within the city. Specific language reads, unless inconsistent with the resolution or code provision governing a particular board, the rules of the quorum set forth in this resolution will apply to all boards of the city, except that the chairman of each city board will be the presiding officer for the respective board. So those are two changes that are not included again in the resolution in the packet. Staff would recommend approval. I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Any questions from the commission?
No, not really a question. I think we do need rules for decorum. I've been yelled at in public meeting. I've had my mayor of Coyo criticized. I've had visits at my house.
But I did hear from something two members of the press, that one was okay, the other one expressed some vague concerns. I think the city manager addressed those. It's a tough position, I'll tell you, because I firmly believe that, you know, our country is built on life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, and freedom of press is paramount to ensuring a free and democratic society, so its government is held accountable to its people. But to Commissioner Bennett's point, we've kind of lost our way in some ways, and that's none of the individuals present here. But we've lost our creativity. It was a recent incident that I suffered as well. The details here, one of the other commissioners did. And I don't know where we forgot we can have different opinions and still be respectful to each other. It's okay to disagree. It's okay not to see everything at the same level, but to hurl the kind of things that said and the kind of threats that have been made, that's not who we are as a people. And the more I say this out loud, the more I'm inclined to support this, because we need to get ourselves on track and have a little respect for each other. And I think it's important that we do that. So I guess that's my long 5 cents to say that, I do agree that we've got to get ourselves back in a position and respect one another, even if we have to fight.
Ron, I couldn't have said it better. So I appreciate the comments. That was well said. My concern is legality. So I would like, you know, just Kurt, if you could just briefly, you know, go through it. Are there any possibilities of opening ourselves up to?
Well, sure. I mean, there's always a potential plan you can twist and turn. And John did strike, suggested that you all strike the provision in Section 6 where it says unwanted interactions. This is a different draft than what originally we found in the minute. So that's a good deletion, I think. That's a little too vague. And I'm sure some of the objections from the media and from others are going to say, well, disruptive behavior. If it's talking loud, or what does that mean? But that all ties back into the following phrase. It says, no person attending a commission meeting shall engage in disruptive behavior, intimidation, harassment, disorderly or boisterous conduct that disturbs, disrupts, or otherwise impedes the orderly conduct of the meeting. You all are elected to serve the public, and you cannot serve the public if you have a person in this audience that causes that kind of disturbance. And so, if somebody talks loudly, that's okay, but it's not okay if it disturbs, disrupts, or otherwise impedes the orderly conduct of the meeting. That's before, during, or after the meeting. And so we've had problems. We've got a much better situation than we've had in the past, but we still have that, and I think you're well justified in doing it. And we may well get a challenge, and if we do, and there's something that needs to be modified, we'll look at that and modify it. But right now, I think you're on good grounds.
Now, you don't see any way, in your experience with case law, of any restriction of freedom of the press in this
resolution?
Oh, no, this resolution.
There are a lot, well, one of the problems that happens sometimes with the press is they will take liberties, some will take liberties, and it will disrupt a meeting, and it makes some people feel uncomfortable. Well, it's part of the, not just the commission, people in the audience. So the main concern is physical interruption or sound interruptions or light interruptions, and that's why I think this resolution gives the city manager the authority to help control that. Certainly the press is encouraged to attend. We like that. We it's important, it's critical, it's a constitutional provision, and there's nothing that we think is just in this that would prohibit that. There are some limitations just to preserve the ability of the commission to carry out the public business. We can't have the press come in and create a disruption just because it's an assertion of the freedom of the press. The paramount business is for the public, and you all serve as the head of the governing body for the city of Winter Garden, and you need to implement that. The mayor is, under this resolution, given the authority to conduct business, and his judgment is going to
Any other discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried unanimously.
And that did include the changes that John read in.
Yes.
Okay. Just a few other items, Mayor, Commission. Just a reminder, this Saturday, 120-year celebration with the Heritage Music Festival, and on February 24th at 7 p.m., the Eastmore Garden Community Development Corporation Scholarship Banquet at Tanner Hall. Please let me know if you'd like to attend. And Kurt touched on it earlier. Just need you guys to confirm back to me if Monday, February 27th at 6 p.m. It's good to host the joint meeting with the Board of Commissioners.
Commissioner Rush.
I do have an announcement about a birthday that's coming up for Miss Wilder. It's no secret she's going to be 90 years old, and I just want to put it out there that it's she's going to have a birthday on the 25th of February. So if you have, you can put that down as a save the date. We'll announce it again at the next meeting, but certainly save the date. It's always an honor to celebrate Miss Wilder, a most important citizen in Winter Garden. So please save that date for and stop by and wish her a happy birthday. Anytime there's an opportunity to, honor a contributor like Miss Wilder to the community, I think we will do so.
12 o'clock.
At 12 o'clock at the Bethlehem Chair. I'm sure we'll get you the details.
Yeah.
So, that's all I have, Mayor. Thank you.
Will the commissioners be singing happy birthday that day?
Yeah, we want her to enjoy her birthday.
Just a couple items for me. Again, my gratitude to the city manager for just all the background things he's been doing the last couple of weeks. It's flowing. He mistakenly thought he could take vacation and had off for a couple of days, but he came back ready to go, and I always appreciate his work. And again, to Steve and Adam, both of those deals, the feedback that they've been on the table is good. It's certainly the purchase of that property. Just kind of gratitude for everything the city's been doing lately. It's been greatly appreciated. A lot of work here. We're getting ready to have some kind of festival this weekend here,
Oh, yeah.
So, city staff is again working hard around the clock all weekend. So, to Laura, her team, Chief Graham, her team, Chief and Dworkin, all the folks that are out there, thank you so much.
Okay. And do remember Saturday's City of Wingard's honey. 120-year anniversary, but at the same time, First Baptist Church. It's got their 135th of the church, 100 year for the building. And they got somebody named Whippy, but I'm not.
I don't have any little kids, so I'm not sure what Whippy is. They got the Warriors coming and everything, so it's going to be a full day downtown Winter Garden Saturday. So with that, we'll let you.